You're on Meet the Press with Barnaby Joyce, and welcome to the panel, Melissa Fyfe from The Age and Malcolm Farr from news.com.au. Good morning to you
both.
Bunch.
On Wednesday night, Julia Gillard received a warm reception at a community cabinet in Brisbane. The locals seemed to appreciate her attacks on the Newman LNP state government. But they were nothing compared with the broadside launched by major LNP donor Clive Palmer.
These books have been cooked by the biggest crooks that have ever occupied office in the state of Queensland. And as a citizen of this state, they need to be accountable.
Senator, good to talk to you. You
G'day, Malcolm.
Were a big mate of the Queensland billionaire at one stage, two plain talking blokes together. Are you still a fan?
Yeah, I'm still a mate of his, so that doesn't change it. You know, I look at Clive Palmer as a person who's very robust in the way he deals with things, but you know, I'm glad he's not an Eddie Obeid or a Mr. McDonald. I mean, New South Wales, there's a place that you can really do some business. Look at that. I mean, that is just out of the ballpark.
He is assisting the Labor Party, which firmly believes that the Campbell-Newman government is the best thing it's got going for it in Queensland.
Well, look, Clive Palmer is a free citizen, and a free citizen has robust comments, and that's the way it is. I'm mates with Clive, and I'm mates with the people on the street, and I take you all as you walk up to me, just like I deal with you, Malcolm. But look, Clive is ventilating because he can't get his way. Now, if he had been in New South Wales, it could have been a different story, because Eddie Obeid likes to do business, and so does Mr. McDonald, and they do business in big licks for their mates. And the story for the Labor right is, how many of those people in federal parliament had a close association with Eddie and with Mr. McDonald? We'd like to know the answer to that question.
Senator, on the Murray plan, you've indicated your willingness to come to the table. What will you compromise on?
Well, we're trying to work to an outcome, but I know that we must have a position that protects the socio-economic integrity, and it's not so much the irrigators, it's the person who lives in the house whose economy is underwritten by that town. They have no right to have the value of their house taken away. So I will work and walk down a path to try and get to some conclusion, but not a conclusion that pulls the economic rug out from underneath the people, the 2.2 million people who live in the basin. Now, I think I'm doing the right thing because Sarah Hanson-Young hates me, so that's a good sign.
But actually, Senator, there's a split, isn't there, in the coalition between the bush and what's best for Adelaide. Have you actually come to a compromise on that within the party?
No, there's no split. There's no split. We've been working very closely with Senator Simon Birmingham, with the people from Adelaide, and I think you can even give them a bell and say, am I trying to do my very best to make sure we keep everybody on at the table? And we are. It is hard. We're trying to work. You need the wisdom of Solomon in this one, which means that you need other people around, except apart from me. And but you know, with Simon Birmingham, with myself, with the guys who actually live in the basin, with the guys in Adelaide and the ladies in the southern part of the Riverina and northern Victoria as well, we can get to an outcome, and we're doing that also working at times in an honest way with the Labor Party. So this just goes to show you, when people say, oh, you can't work together, you can't work, you know, across party lines, we can when it's for the benefit of the nation, and we're doing our very best endeavours to do it. But what Sarah Hanson-Young wants to do, as per normal, is ride in as the, you know, prophet from over the hill and just completely and utterly destroy the joint.
What's your compromise with the government? What are you going to offer the government?
Well, we're just trying to get to a point. See, it's a bit hard, Malcolm, because we've got to wait at the end till the plan is tabled, the intergovernmental agreement is tabled, the water recovery strategy is known, and we haven't actually seen any of those three documents at this point in time. So we're still working in this flux towards trying to make sure that if we are going to save water in a very sort of rudimentary form, we'll save it by delivering a better sprinkler, not by pulling the sprinkler out. And that's, I know that's, people say that's puerile, but I'm trying to paint a picture that the Australian people can understand. This is about better technology to get greater efficiencies is where we've got to be concentrating our effort, because if we start just taking the water out of circulation completely, then how do we call ourselves the food basket of Southeast Asia? Well, we won't even be the food basket for Australia. We'll shut down our own capacity to feed ourselves.
Just very briefly and finally, on that point, I see where the people who are getting the money from the Chinese investors in the Ord River say it's good for them, good for Australia, good for Australian food production. You'd have to agree with them, wouldn't you?
Well, to be honest, the Ord is probably a slightly better position than what happened in Cubby. And what happened in Cubby is had a fully developed entity of freehold land that was just sold holeless bolus overseas, and it got sailed through the Foreign Investment Review Board, and the only conditions that were put up were the ones that the foreign investor suggested. But at least with the Ord, they're actually developing land. They're actually building a sugar mill. It is actually a lease, and it's a private entity. So it's not perfect, but it's better than what we had. But what we must understand is, and you've seen it today, is the amount of foreign investment that is happening in Queensland, which is the only state that has a true foreign investment register, has had an exponential increase. There is a trajectory of massive growth. Now, we must concentrate on that.
All right. Thank you very much for joining us today, Barnaby Joyce.
Always a pleasure, Paul.
Well, after the break, the looming Royal Commission, a view from Catholics demanding reform. And no more little secrets for cartoonist Kathy Wilcox in the Sydney Morning Herald.
It'll be our little secret. It'll be our little secret. It'll be our little secret.
It won't be our little secret.